Okay, in this video, I'm going to look at serving the LLaMA2 70 billion model in the cloud. And I'll probably do a few videos of different ways to do this. This is one that I came across, which I think is kind of interesting. One, I'll show you where you can sort of play with this for free, but then also a service that you could use their API and pay per second of prediction. So we'll have a look at that. So if you can look here, this is LLaMA2.ai, the domain LLaMA2.ai allows us to play around with the 70 billion parameter. And it's basically sponsored by A16Z, a venture capital firm. So one of the things that you can do here that I really like is you can come in and you can actually play with the system prompt in here. Now, I don't think the Hugging Face one lets you do this. So the cool thing here is that with the bigger models, it pays more attention to the system prompt. So you can see here, I'm saying to it, okay, you are helpful, but totally drunk assistant. You slur your words and spell badly a lot. So let's see, when we say morning, how are you to it? How does it actually go with this? Okay, we can see that our model is now starting to return back our drunk assistant. And sure enough, it seems to be slurring a lot of its words and also not hugely belling, but just sort of slurring spelling where it's basically using repeating characters and stuff again. When I ask it, can you tell me about the Olympics just to show you this? You will find that at different times of the day, the speed of the reply takes longer to come through. I don't think this is longer actually computing. I think you're just waiting for it to basically reply and come back. So you can see, okay, our thing has replied. We've got this pretty unhelpful assistant here that we've been chatting to. Now, what I want to do is jump in and look at the startup that is serving that model behind the scenes. So this is replicate.com. And you can see that they're serving a whole bunch of different models. So you can serve private models here, but they also have public APIs for models that you can try out. So I think there are a number of companies doing this kind of thing. One of them was Mosaic and they got bought. I don't know what's happened now with them and they never seem to actually open up their inference API for people to use. But here we've basically got Replicate where we can go through, you can see they're serving a bunch of the different image models. We've got audio generation models. But the thing that we're really after is the LLaMA2 language models here. And so sure enough, we've got a number of different llamas here. We click in and have a look at this model. We can see that it's got an API that you can basically use for this. We can see that it's running the system prompt like we tried on the Andreessen Horowitz one. My guess is that Andreessen Horowitz probably is an investor in this company, and that's why they're using this. But it has everything that we want to be able to run this in the cloud and even stream our responses back for this. So if we jump in and have a look at the pricing here is determined basically by what hardware you use. So you can see here that we know that the LLaMA2 model is running on an NVIDIA A180 GPU. So that is basically costing 0.32 cents per second or 19 cents per minute. Now, the difference here is you're not paying for just endless uptime. You're only paying for when it's actually making predictions. So only when you call it and it's running, making your prediction, and it's sent back, you're just paying for that time of the model. This is quite different than, say, serving a model on the Hugging Face inference or on a lot of other things where you're paying for the actual time that the server is up and the GPU is up there. This is quite a different thing. Now, depending on, I'm not going to say that this is always going to be cheaper. I think if you're putting this into production, you'd probably be maybe better at looking at something else and serving it yourself. But if you compare this to something like AWS, where people are serving these models, and it's often costing them over $30 an hour to have that infrastructure up, running, and having the model running. So in this case, we don't need to do any of that. There's not even a sort of cold start problem here of waiting for it because we're using the public hosted version of this. Now, we could host our own custom models in here as well. Then we would also have to pay for sort of the startup time that was going on for that as well. So another good thing is when you actually sign up, you can get your API token. You don't need to put in a credit card straight away. They will actually give you some amount of credits to try out the service, to test it out. I encourage you, even if you just want to see, okay, what's LLaMA 2, 70 billion, and if, you know, I mess with this, what will it be like? Rather than just go to the LLaMA.ai website and just play with it, if you want to actually play with it yourself, you can have come along here and have a look at that. So they've got a whole docs section where you can basically use it with different kinds of services. There's lots of examples here. They've even got a collab here. I'm actually not going to go through that one here. That sort of seems to focus more on their image model stuff. What I'm going to do is we're going to go through a notebook of using this with LangChain and looking at how you could use it with LangChain. So we're now in the collab to basically look at using LLaMA 2 with Replicate and using it with LangChain. And you see that you'll get your Replicate API token and you'll put it in here. And then you just import the LLM as Replicate and you set it up something like this. You basically go to Replicate and get the key for the model. So you can see here, this is using the LLaMA 13 billion. This is in one of their examples. You run it through and then you will basically get this back. You can also stream it out. If we're streaming something out, we can run through and we can see that, okay, the streaming will come out quite nicely. And it's quite quick. So this is using the 13 billion. Even with the 70 billion, you will see that the streaming is pretty decent in here. So this is the 70 billion model. And obviously the streaming is slower, but we are getting the streaming coming through on Colab. It tends to go very wide here. But we can see that, okay, we've got streaming going along nicely. And this is a LLaMA 2 model running at full resolution in here. So I've just taken the notebook from the previous video and just converted that across. It actually doesn't require much conversion at all. You can see that, okay, here we've basically just gotten rid of the pipeline for when we were running the 7B in here. And we've now swapped it out with the LLM so that we're running the 70B in here. So we've got the summarization and stuff like that that we did in the previous video. You'll see here that I've got streaming coming back and I've also got at the end, it prints it out. I'm not sure. So that the streaming one on top, it doesn't wrap it. And where with this one, it is wrapping it. We've got a simple chatbot that's the same as what I did in the previous video. In the future, we'll have a look at using this with some tools and some other stuff as well. You can see that here it's able to go through a sort of conversation. And I've put in the time so we can just see the wall time of roughly how long these are taking to predict. So you will see when I ask the one about the Olympics, it does actually take 62 seconds to come back. So that's costing us around 19 cents. It's not cheap to run these models in the cloud. And this is where I often think that people give OpenAI a hard time for the cost there. If you're going to run these things in production, you often find that running your own models can be very expensive. The advantage that you have here, obviously, is that you can fully fine-tune this yourself and set it up the way that you want it, as opposed to OpenAI, currently where we can't do that. You will find that most of the responses are in pretty decent times for a 70 billion full resolution model. So this just gives you one advantage of basically using Replicate to serve this kind of model. You can actually do the fine-tuning on Replicate as well. I'm not going to be looking at that in this video. We just wanted to look at getting the full 70B model up so that we can then use it for some other things. I'm also going to look at getting this going. I know a lot of people are really eager with the 4-bit ones. So I'm trying out a bunch of different 4-bit ones to work out what I think is going to be the best for that currently. Anyway, as always, if you've got questions, please feel free to put them in the comments below. If you're interested in seeing more videos for this kind of stuff, please click and subscribe. And I will talk to you in the next video. Bye for now.